Hi everyone and welcome back. Today I'm going to review a new product. It's a glitter paste and I'm going to share 6 cards using all the colors as well as 2 tote bags. So let's start. These are the new Icing Diamond 24 carats glitter paints. They work as glitter pastes but you can use them as paints as well. As you can see, there is a big range of colors. There are 16 of them in the range currently. You can use these on paper, on textile, on wood, pretty much any surface. And the color that you see where the diamond is the actual color. This is a transparent window. This whole range is a second version of the Icing paints, glitter paints. And this one, the whole range, is called 24 carats and it has a holographic look and feel to it. Now, what I find really special about these paints is that they come in this kind of a pouch that doesn't let air come through, which means that the paste is not going to dry out. Now, you can tell that this packaging is from the new 24 carats range because it has a little diamond up there in pink. I'm going to bring in one from the original range and you can see it doesn't have that pink. Now I'm going to compare both of them and I'll do that with a silver paint so you can see the difference. Probably you can tell from the window that this is holographic, the new range, and as you can see I have the whole collection since the brand sent it to me. So in order to make this video helpful, I'm going to use each and every one of those colors so you can see them in action and then you can decide what works for you. Remember, there is a 20% off discount on the links down below. So before I go ahead and start making projects, I have a white and a black cardstock here. I'm going to apply first the new 24 carat silver paint, just with my spatula, both on white and on black cardstock. And then I'm going to take a small amount of silver from the original range, so you can see the difference. The original one definitely looks chunkier. I don't know if the glitter is bigger in the original collection. And the glitter in the new collection is holographic and it definitely looks thinner, finer. In any case, you don't need both silvers. I would say just pick up different colors than the ones that you have already in your collection. I also want to show you how the white looks on both white and black. This is really magic. On white, it's beautiful. I think it would make the perfect snow. And on black, it completely changes color. Just because it is holographic, it looks like green. So keep that in mind if you grab the white one. Now I'm going to play with all the different colors in the range so you can see them in action. It's really fun. I'm going to create many different backgrounds and then we are going to turn them into cards. I'm also going to use some of the colors on tote bags, which make really beautiful gifts. So for the first one, I am applying the black one. I'm adding a little bit of paste on my spatula and apply it. I don't want to add too much from the beginning because there is no way to put the paste back in the tube. However, there is a big advantage on this pouch on the packaging because it doesn't let air come inside and your paste is not going to dry. I will remove the stencil so we can see the beautiful background. I will leave this to dry and I have a bowl full of water where I'm going to dip in my stencil and I will wash it later on. So every time I'm using a stencil, I will just dip it in the water and leave it there. So this time I'm playing with another stencil and the color that I'm using is red. By the way, the stencil I'm using here is called Leaves and Berries by Altenew and you will find it linked down below along with every other product that you see me use on this video. The previous stencil was the City Scene. So here again I'm going to peel off my stencil, leave the background to dry and I'm going to dip the stencil in water. I'm going to show you all the backgrounds at the end once everything is dry and you can see all the beautiful shine. Now for this background I'm working with a floral garden stencil which has 2 areas, the one with the leaves and the other one with the flowers. So first I'm going over with my ink and a sponge dabber to add the leaves. Then I will switch to yellow and just add the center of the flowers. And I could have done that with my glitter paste but it could take ages for the first layer to dry so that I can do the flowers next, so I decided to just do it with ink. Now all you do is to flip the stencil and those flowers fall in between the leaves, and they are in perfect position. This time I am combining two different colors of paste, which are pink and dark pink. So first I am applying a little bit on each flower from the lighter pink, and then with my spatula I will move on and start adding the darker one. These blend beautifully together. You can do the blending on your craft mat and then apply it on your stencil if you like. I just do it directly on top, as I don't really care where each color is going to go. I just want to have some variation on my flowers so they will look more dimensional and not as flat. I'm going to peel off the stencil and you can see the reveal. I leave that aside to dry and the stencil goes inside my bowl of water. And now for my favorite color combo. So this is the white. Well, I call it white, but it's actually called pearly. Then I'm moving on to turquoise. And then lastly, I will add the darker shade, which is blue. So here I'm going for an ombre effect. And I'm using a lovely stencil, which is called Diamond Snowflakes. For the next card, I'm going to use a large stencil, which is called Floral Drape. I always secure my stencils on top of the card base by using some purple tape, or you can use washi tape or whatever low-tack tape you have. This is going to make sure that you will have a good application and nice and neat. And I'm combining here two different shades, which are the yellow and the orange. And I absolutely love the time when I lift the stencil and see the result. They all look so pretty with all that glitter. And of course the fun part is that you play with glitter without the mess of glitter, since this is going to stay put on your project. So for this background I'm working with a beautiful butterfly stencil, and I'm going to combine three different colors of ice ink. This time I'm applying purple at the outer edge of the wings. Then I will move on to peach. Notice that as I add the new color, I make sure that I blend it slightly with the previous one, so I have a good transition. And finally I'm going to finish it off by adding gold at the center. Again doing a little bit of blending. I'm going to peel off the stencil and you can see the beautiful result. This is absolutely stunning. And since this product works on textile, I decided to create a couple of tote bags as my backgrounds were drying. So here I'm going to insert a hard cardstock inside so I have a nice and flat area to work on. I'm going to apply a stencil on top, and you can use that low-tack spray at the back of a stencil if you want to make sure that this is going to stay in place. I just taped it down and it worked fine for me. So I'm going to start at the bottom and I'm using turquoise here, lovely color, just stunning. Then I'm going to move to green pastel. So again I'm going to apply the color and blend it slightly with the previous one. And finally I'm going to finish it off by adding a little bit of a light gold. Again, I'm going to apply it over the stencil and blend it slightly with the rest of the colors. Now I'm going to remove the stencil and you can see the lovely design. I think it makes a lovely tote. It's great to fill it in with little gifts and hand it out to someone. Plus, this is permanent on fabric and it is washable as well. And here is a close-up photo once that paste was dry, where you can see the beautiful shine. Now I'm going to work on a black tote. Again, I have a cardstock inside, so I have a nice and flat area to work on. I'm also going to do some cleaning, making sure that my area is completely clean. I don't want any ginger cut hair to stick with the paste there. So anyway, I'm going to secure my stencil on top, which has lots of stars. And this time I'm going with a silver paste. I'm just going to apply it all over the place, completely covering the stars. And now let's remove the stencil and see the result. Now, I absolutely love this one. I won't be giving it away as a gift. I'm going to keep it for myself. And let's take a close-up look on all those holographic silver stars. Now, as I was making the tote bags, my background were drying, so here they are all dried out. I'm going to show them to you, trying to catch the light so you can see all the different colors that I used. So this is the orange and the yellow, the pink ones, all the purples and the gold at the center, and finally my favorites, which are the shades of blue and the white. So now I'm going to turn all of these into really quick and simple cards. For the first one, I'm using silver background and I cut out the words Peace on Earth, which I'm going to stick them down with my Nouveau Deluxe glue. And to add some extra shine on my card, I'm going to add some dots of glue at the background, and then I'm going to stick on top some silver gems. I'm trying to pick up the tiniest of them, so they are going to look as stars at the sky. You can see here a close-up photo. This is a super shiny card, and hopefully you can see the shine of the glitter. And here are some close-up photos. For the next card, I'm placing my background on a red card base, and I just placed a little circle and the word joy on top. The word joy is cut out of gold, so it gives a more festive look. Now remember, with such stunning backgrounds, with all that shine and glitter, you don't really need to do a lot on top of them. They are already busy and they are the focal point of your cards. So here I'm combining two sentiments, the word hello along with a thin strip that says sending you lots of love, and my card is finished. Now for this background, I cut it out to be smaller than the standard card, so I have some borders on each side, and again I'm combining a couple of sentiments that read, thanks, you are all kinds of amazing. For this one, I created a card base out of blue cardstock, and I'm going to place my background on top. For my sentiment, I'm going with the word joy that I have already cut out. These all come from a set by My Favorite Things, and I cut out all those pieces using the same cardstock as my card base, so everything matches. Now the letter O has a little die-cut string on top, so it looks like an ornament. I'm going to stick down the letters J and Y, and I'm going to complete it with a thin strip of paper that says To the World. I have white embossed that. And here are some close-up photos to the finished card. And now finally to the stunning butterfly, I'm going to stick that on top of a card base that is purple. I looked through my stash to find some color that matches the colors of the butterfly. I'm going to finish it off by sticking a sentiment at the center of my butterfly. And here are some close-up photos on this card. And these were the projects for today, as I was playing with the new iZinc 24 Carats glitter paste. Don't forget, you will find links down below to everything I used. So I hope that you had fun, that you got inspired. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you haven't done so already. And let me know in the comments below if you like the tote bag projects and if you want me to create another video making more tote bags for gifts. Thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you all next time.